Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky back here in the laboratory with a short clinic on working with photo etch parts. We are bathing our build, getting it ready, so this is a good opportunity to work on some other things, including photo etch, which is this. It's mostly brass and it's beautiful, and you don't want to really apply it like this. You have to get it ready, and some people paint it and others just basically use a liquid, that blue liquid back there, and you basically just dip it in the liquid for a little bit and it'll turn. You are going to need tweezers, right? And you are gonna need a brand new hobby blade. Very, very easy to do. Most of these parts have these little tags, just like plastic. And what you do is you go around them, cutting them when you hear that little snap. Okay, there it is. The part has been cut off. All right, now it'll still have these little tags here. So you have to, let me see if I can bring the part closer and have it be, there we go. Yes, that's what it looks like. Absolutely beautiful. But you see the little tag right there. So you file that down. You file it down. All right, once you cut it, you put it on there. Okay, you put it in a little plastic container. Nothing will happen to it. Do not throw away your spare, you know, the little leftover, because you could still use it. I mean, it's wonderful metal, and you could still use it. Okay, that's the side window. Okay, into the little tub there, and this one, of course, is connected by four little connection pins, little tags. So normally, I removed the little flash using the file before, but we're already set up for this. So that's the windshield into the little vat. Keep this. This is very good because you can cut it and you can use it when you need a little bit of metal for bracing your exhaust or adding hooks and all kinds of wonderful stuff. So don't throw this out. Of course, the chain is also brass, so the chain goes into the little bath, and we're gonna shake it up. Of course, open it and pour just enough so that it covers the surface there, just like so. Okay, and we will swish it around. Eventually, it starts to become discolored. Very quickly becomes discolored, and then it gets very dark. It becomes tarnished. The longer you leave it, the darker it gets. And so we want it pretty dark. The other thing that I wanted to mention was, for those of you looking for mesh, this is about the right size mesh that I use for a 1/24th scale for my windows. If you killed me, I could not begin to tell you where I got this from, although there's a product, and I think that's exactly where I got it from. Let me show you the company, because this is the place, and oh wait, as a matter of fact, I have a little bit of extra here that, and once you see it, you can get it at Michael's, you can get it practically everywhere. And lots of it. One little package will last you a lifetime. There it is. Wire form. Okay, look for this at Michael's or, you know, wherever else. Okay, that's it. And it comes with, I mean, I'll open it so you see what I'm talking about. Like a whole big, you know, big chunk of it. This will last you a lifetime. Okay. You can cut it with, for example, you can make headlight covers with this stuff using a hole puncher. okay? Hole punchers have become really cheaply made, so sometimes you have a little bit of trouble. Okay, wire form, yes indeedy. So look for it, but hole punchers, and you make all sorts of neat stuff. Headlight covers, any kind of a lens cover that you want to use, you know, screening a floor of a rat rod. It's got multiple wonderful uses, so look for it. Get your hands on it. Let's see, does it have a size? Yes, it says 100% aluminum contour mesh, 1/16 or 1.58 millimeter pattern, one sheet. It's 16 inches by 20 inches. So that's what you want, all right? Those of you who have been asking me, I thought I'd be useful and let you know. Here we go, the magic at work, okay? See that? That's all I wanted to show you. So in essence, the clinic is finished. Now, I don't know if you can see it, the chain is not turning, so that's gonna sit in there for a little bit longer. But you see what it did to it, and that's what you want. You could repolish it and bring it back to its original state, but why do that? I mean, this is going on a zombie hunter, the zombie baiter. So that's pretty much it. That's the end of the clinic. Have fun with your styrene and enjoy the show. Come back for more. There's always more, my friends, here at the Lab-RAT-ory. Right, Igor? Right! Hey, wait a minute. Igor sounds just like Scooby-Doo. Isn't that amazing that when you think of imitating a dog, that's what, you know, that's how we've been all programmed by cartoons. Right on, Scooby! I mean, Dr. Cranky! Oh! Anyway, enough fun. Keep building, my friends. Keep sharing. That's what it's all about. Until next time, Dr. Cranky here in the lab. Say it. Ori.